know, no, none of that science. But I can tell you that, you know, that's all I can do. So definitely do that. My granddaddy tells us we are living in troubled times. Says that revolution is more than just rocking a t-shirt or throwing up a sign. Revolution must reach us all. Whether you stand in the picket line, voting at the polls, or standing or swinging on one, revolution must be monumental. And I know a generation that may get your attention. Hip hop, you the love of my life. Even though the world is causing me strife, I'ma rhyme from the dawn to the light. Pay attention, we gonna go to new heights. You see, a tribe called Quest, cause we discovered truth. A tribe called You, cause we discovered proof that we can do anything. Tell our stories as long as we got a booth. DJ Bless on the beat, I don't waste time. I ain't a dealer, but you know I keep up. Not to mention educated, dedicated, some say intellectual, extraterrestrial, I take you to the cosmos. Pluto, Mars, Saturn, then maybe to Mexico, or maybe to the islands. England, Finland, then Ireland. Cali, then New York City, where MC Light wanna get gully. LL Cool J said love me, but I like Rakim and Doug E. Concrete jungle, yes, I am the black rose, cause the grind never stops until your casket is closed. Trekking through all the woes, the pain, it never gets old. Trying to get to what's real, just sifting through all these fables, but you never know what side your hand is on when it's dealt under the table. And most days, the world seems like it's completely fatal. I'm trying to get the key to health, wealth, and happiness. Government trying to stop. School to prison pipeline is looking like a Nazi. America builds more prisons than elementary schools and tells children to go get an education. But how can they get a quality education when more money is being spent on making sales than it is on producing paper? $1 billion pigeonholes trying to get these residuals. They making profits off of bodies, but call me a criminal? Capitalism got you by the neck. It's trying to choke you. And Coca-Cola's taking all my money, so I'm broke too. And ain't no guarantee that I'm going to use my degree, because no one wants to pay a social worker to get the change they want to see. We want fast food, but don't want to pay people who flip burgers. Want to piss in a clean toilet, then turn around and shit on employees who fight to raise minimum wage. Like they don't deserve 15 an hour. I am sick of the privilege telling others how to live. And racism ain't nothing but capitalism's bastard kid. Will be quick to say you don't see color and all lives matter. Yet I don't hear a sound when refugees need some place to sleep. Sean Bell shot down, murdered in the streets. And some probably don't even know who that is, because they don't have to. The system is designed for their protection. It's a mess, and let me not forget my all-time favorite. Insert Dr. King quote here. Yet conveniently forget about the one where he says, a riot is the voice of the unheard. I got reasons to be mad. And let's not get it twisted. I ain't my ancestors. I will
beat your ass.
So don't come for me, and I won't send for you. Yes. You can go tell that to the Uncle Toms and Uncle Ruckus too. Ain't no time to be polite to a white supremacist system. One that swallows fathers, brothers, and sisters like Rakia, Latasha, Melissa, Yvette, Sandra, and the list goes on. I'd be a fool to believe my name can't be added too. I refuse to stand by and watch this world victimize black and brown people. Poor people, trans people. So call me mad, radical. Call me the angry black woman. If wanting to see these people live makes me all that, then what are you? Take me back, go on and take me back. Take me back, go on and take me back. Take me back, go on and take me back. Take me back, go on and take me back. There's a funeral in my bedroom today. This casket body does not feel normal. Like love, home, a place I'm supposed to want to live in, I crawl out of the skin today. Not put up with the weight of these bones, be done with myself, I hear. Death is unexpected. But I have seen death come before. See it every time I flash back to 2004, smelling scents of whiskey and fear every day after school. Today, I am 10 years old again. I am the little girl watching a home crumble before her eyes. I am witness to a war raging right inside of my own home. My parents never had much of a marriage. They were married, but what's a wedding ring to loophole infidelity? Same house, vows, same creaky floors, separate bedrooms, same graveyard silence. Some days it was like living among the walking dead. I wonder, or my father would float out of the door. door on Friday, slipped back in with a bag full of clothes on Sunday nights while my mother only cried on Monday mornings. I soon discovered that my father is a wanderer, not good at staying in the same places for long periods of time, not the best at remembering either. Always losing things with no recollection of what he left them, his keys, wallets, heart. Always misplacing pieces of himself in places that don't belong to him. I realized he was the cause of my mother's hurt. She kept a bed warm for him that he forgot to come back to. And soon, her tears dried up. She wiped them with sheets reminiscent of a husband she forgot she even had. One night, she placed a knife to his throat, the same one used to swallow lies, fear, and all the women he had outside of their marriage. I watched in the next room as I quickly saw silence turn to cries, cries into screams, screams into booms. Watch this marriage blow to pieces. Spent my childhood caught in a war on two fronts. One, a soldier fighting a battle she did not sign up for. The other, waging war he never intended to finish. Threw in the white flag, left his people to die. My mother and I know all too well what a civil war feels like. How to bear scars of men who do not love back. How parents sometimes make decisions that affect their children, break the core, and now healing just doesn't come easy. But I forgive you, Daddy. I am not a little girl anymore. I still die a little inside sometimes, but I know I have to build a new home. Pull myself out of this grave, fix a house up with the chips and dirt you left me, and try my best to learn forgiveness and celebrate life my bedroom every day. Ooh.